Happy Hooves, OOO, by Anna Bogie. It was Christmas Eve and snow was falling. Cow had been singing carols all morning. Her barn was decked with tinsel and holly. The festive season made her feel jolly. Where were her friends, the Happy Hooves bunch? Cow found them nearby, sleeping off lunch.
"Wake up," she yelled. "There's no time to lose. I can't believe you're having a snooze."
She shook her head in disbelief.
"Let me explain,"
through gritted teeth.
"You can't be lazy. Let's do things right, or Santa won't come down the chimney tonight. Now tidy up, make everything gleam, even on top of the dusty old beam. No crumbs on the floor, no dirt can be seen. Santa must see how good you've all been."
The pig swiftly ran to his humble abode, wiped off the mud and got rid of a toad. Evicting a mob of mischievous slugs, he then chased away a family of bugs. But something was wrong when Pig looked up high. No chimney for Santa in his sty.
"Ho, ho, ho!"
"Is that Santa I hear? Oh, 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 he must be near."
The pig was worried and ran to the sheep.
"Do you have space for me to sleep?"
"Of course," sheep said. "You're welcome to stay, but I need to clean up straight away."
The sheep ran off to his drafty house, opened the door and threw out a mouse. He dusted the rafters, startled a bat, whose flapping escape scared off a rat. But something was missing above sheep's head.
No chimney for Santa in his shed.
"Ho, ho, ho.
Is that Santa I hear? Oh, 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 he must be near."
Now sheep and pig were in distress and hoped that Donkey could solve this mess.
"Sleep here with me,"
Donkey cried.
"But I must tidy up. It's mucky inside."
The donkey jogged to his room in the yard and hung up his last Christmas card. He brushed away the old yellow straw, a pile of twigs and an apple core. But something looked odd on Donkey's wall. No chimney for Santa in his stall.
"Ho, ho, ho.
Is that Santa I hear? Oh, oh, oh. He must be near."
Pig, sheep and donkey were now uptight, so asked the foal for a bed for the night.
"Come in," foal said, "and have 40 winks. Though I must clear these dishes, something stinks."
Foal dashed around her cozy shack and shooed off the cats who were having a yak. She washed and swept to clean every spot, unearthing the culprit, a mouldy pot. But something seemed strange above foal's table. No chimney for Santa in her stable.
"Ho, ho, ho.
Is that Santa I hear? Oh, 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 he must be near."
The donkey, the pig, the sheep and the foal raced to the cow by the waterhole.
"Oh, cow, this news will make you glum. We've got no chimneys for Santa to come."
Cow chuckled loudly.
"Santa won't care. He can deliver gifts anywhere. If your home is a stall, a barn or a shed, he'll find the stocking by your bed. If you live in a stable or even a sty, he'll always come if you leave a mince pie. But now you are here, have Christmas with me. Let's spend it together around the tree. It's cold outside, come in from the snow. I hear Santa laughing, ho, ho, ho. We've all been good, so he'll find a way to deliver our presents on Christmas Day."
Happy Hooves, OOO, by Anna Bogie. Illustrated by Rebecca Elliott. Narrated by Helen Langford. Get your copy of Happy Hooves 000 in bookstores now. A story video in collaboration with MyVoxSongs YouTube channel. Watch MyVoxSongs Fairy Tale Stories. Subscribe today for more children's videos. Just click here.